السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, teach us what benefit us from what He taught us and increase us in knowledge. اللهم بارك لنا في جمعنا هذا واجعله تجمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put barakah in this gathering and make us from the people at the end of the gathering they will be told قوموا مغفورا لكم قد بدلت سيئاتكم حسنات. Get up, all your sins are forgiven and your sins have been switched and turned into good deeds. آمين يا رب العالمين. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. First, I want to express my gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal for making me from the people who made it to Hajj and back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from me and from all the people who went to Hajj this year from all over the world. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. It was compared to Allah bless me that I went a couple of times to Hajj already, and from previous experiences, subhanAllah, this year was an amazing, amazing year. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It was very, very easy Hajj. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It was, it has some taysir from Allah Azza wa Jal in every aspect of it, in every aspect. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, from Mina to Arafah to Muzdalifah to Tawaf, and all the manasik were, alhamdulillah, very, very easy and made, of course, by Allah Azza wa Jal. And we have to give credit to the brothers, and mainly the brothers in the Saudi over there, mashallah. There were really thousands and thousands of people that were just dedicated to help and direct and assist the Hajjis, whether it's from medical situations or somebody's lost or someone, or from cleaning, thousands of people cleaning. It was, you could notice the difference this year. You could really notice the difference. Even the airport, there was no wait, and it was amazing, mashallah. And you feel that the improvement, which is great. And I heard that next year is even they have the smart card, and you could just, alhamdulillah, they're getting there, inshallah ta'ala. But to have 2.5 million people, this is what the estimate was this year, 2.37. And to have them all in one place at the same time, doing the same thing from different cultures, different ethnicities, different languages, different traditions, and be able to accommodate all these people, wallahi, needs a tremendous amount of work. And alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you could notice the difference. And I don't know about other Hajjis, but alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, it was an amazing Hajj. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept, and may Allah grant all the brothers and sisters who did not go this year, inshallah ta'ala, to be able to make it next year, inshallah. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Wallahi, like I said before I leave, if you make the sincere intention, Allah will get you ways and sources you've never expected. But all it needs is sincere intention. Sincere intention. There was one sister in our group that, خلاص, we closed the group, we're done. And please, my brother is going, and this is the only chance I have a mahram going. Ya akhti, I'll try. And subhanAllah, by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, she was able to go to Hajj with her brother and come back. And subhanAllah, she had a wonderful Hajj. So it's all about, they can't hear us. Okay, maybe you can open the door a little bit, Brother Imran. Just to the, oh, Brother, okay, Brother Basir is here. He'll take care of it, inshallah. Brother Basir, you want to see why? Okay. So I'll scream, inshallah. So alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, we are back, and thank you so much for all your dua. Subhanallah. Before I leave, as you have noticed, I was praying on a chair. Wallahi, ya akhwan, I'm explaining the names of Allah Azza wa Jal. And before we leave, we mentioned Al-Jabbar. So I said, Ya Jabbar, ujbur rukbati. I asked the Jabbar to fix my knee. And Allahi, and if you ever go to Hajj, you know how much walking is involved. Wallahi, how did it happen? No other explanation. No other explanation. It's only from Allah. And when Hajj was over, my knee came back. It started hurting again. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Because I begged Allah. You see, my dua was wrong. I said, Ya Allah, please, please, Ya Allah. I kept on begging Allah. Ya Allah, make me perform the Hajj without my knee hurting. I did not say, khalas, fix my knee completely. I asked for a specific thing. Okay, that's what you want. Okay, Bismillah. Subhanallah. So when I finished, I said, Ya Allah, yeah, my knee is back. It's hurting. So the last sa'i, I had to do the last two rounds. I did the 5, 6, and 7. I did them on a wheelchair. This is how bad. Subhanallah. But Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, everything else in general was amazing, inshaAllah ta'ala. طيب, we go back to the names of Allah Azza wa Jal. And like we were told by our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that whomsoever learn and understand and apply and live and implement these names and these attributes and the meaning of them in his life, Jannah will be guaranteed. Paradise will be guaranteed. It seems very simple, but it is to understand them and to understand their relevance to Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these names and attributes to know him better. But no matter what we try, our main and our intellect and our comprehension cannot be able to understand who is Allah Azza wa Jal. The only one who knows Allah Azza wa Jal is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do our best through his names and attributes, but at the end of the day, we do it as a form of getting close to Allah Azza wa Jal. We do it in a way to understand and appreciate and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a better manner. So today, inshallah ta'ala, like I promised you to make it short, today's two names of Allah Azza wa Jal. Since we finished the ayah, we were going through the ayah.
هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون.
So we finished Al-Jabbar, and today is Al-Mutakabbir. Al-Mutakabbir. Al-Mutakabbir, and another name, they come from the same source, Kaf Ba Ra, which means Kabura or Kibr. And the other name is, what's other name comes from Kabara? Al-Kabir. Al-Kabir. Al-Kabir and Al-Mutakabbir, they have the same root, which is Kaf Ba Ra. Now, Kabara or Kabir has three kinds of meanings. Either the Kabir will be in size, like I would say, can the brothers in the back be quiet? Yes, young men over there. Can we say like this, هذا مسجد كبير. This is a big masjid. It could be كبير, it could be in size, it could be in age. هذا رجل كبير. يعني شيخ كبير. يعني he is an old man. Or it could be in knowledge. Not knowledge, in general, it could be in status. يعني هذا, this is هذا كبير مسؤول كبير. Yeah, this is a big known scholar, president, leader, كبير. So it could be any of these three. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-kabir in every aspect, in every aspect. There are some of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal that we try to emulate. Like for example, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, من لا يرحم الناس من لا يرحم لا يرحم. Whomsoever does not give rahmah will not receive rahmah. So that means the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman, we should emulate and have mercy on others. But this name, and like Al-Jabbar, we said Al-Jabbar, we cannot emulate. You cannot be Jabbar on others, except in a form of just trying to console them. But in general, Tajabbur is not something recommended. Only, it's perfection only when it comes to Allah. Similarly, Al-Mutakabbir, the proud, is only a perfect attribute when it comes to Allah. But when it comes to a human being, he is arrogant, because takabbur is arrogance in Arabic. When you see somebody is mutakabbir, it's not a good attribute, it's a negative human attribute. But when it comes to Allah Azza wa Jal, it is perfection. It is perfection. What does it mean when we say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mutakabbir? It means that He is mutakabbir, He is above any kind of evil. He is above any deficiency. He is above any oppression. He will not oppress anyone of His slaves. He is above any kind of human faults or human needs, like we all need to eat, to drink, to sleep. Allah is mutakabbir, is beyond all that, is above all that. The name Al-Kabir was mentioned in the Quran in six places. Like, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه الباطل وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. This is because Allah is the truth, and that which they call upon other than Him is falsehood. And because Allah is Al-Ali, the Most High, and He is the Al-Kabir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in another place in Surah Ghafir, ذَلِكُمْ بِأَنَّهُ إِذَا دُعِيَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ كَفَرْتُمْ وَإِنْ يُشْرَكْ بِهِ تُؤْمِنُوا فَالْحُكْمُ لِلَّهِ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. And the name Al-Mutakabbir is only mentioned once in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hashr also, in the ayah we just recited. Kibriya in general, linguistically, means greatness and sovereignty. And it encompasses the meaning of the perfection of one's self and existence. Nobody can be described as such except Allah Azza wa Jal. And now the name Al-Kabir, when we get acquainted with this name, subhanAllah, it gives you peace and tranquility. Because no matter what you are going through, Allah is greater than that. When I'm going through any kind of difficulty, and I think of the name Al-Kabir, my Kabir problem will become Sagir, will become very small. Because I can request from the Kabir to take care of it. So like they say, do not say I have a huge problem, I have a great problem. Say I have a great ilah that will solve any problem. I have a great ilah that will solve any problem. That will solve any problem. So, and subhanAllah, if you notice, like I mentioned one time, if you look at what is the most statement that we say on a daily basis, which means the most statement that we say in our life, and that was Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. If you think about it, and I did all the calculation, it is the most word that we say on a daily basis. The Salat only, if you count the Salat, comes out to 92 times a day, we say it in the Salat. Then 33 times after every Salat. Then 34 before we sleep. Then if we repeat after the Mu'adhin also. And so many times, subhanAllah. So Allahu Akbar will give you so much peace, and it will make you, for example, in the Salat, every time I'm about to get distracted, Allahu Akbar, come back, forget about your wife and your children and your business, and come back to the Salat. You're meeting with Allah, and then I get distracted again. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah, there's a hikmah why it's Allahu Akbar, not Subhanallah or Alhamdulillah every time I move from one rukun to another. And that According to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is one of the words that Allah loves the most. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the four most beloved words to Allah: Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Allahu akbar, I just came back from Hajj. Allahu Akbar is when we start the tawaf. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. You raise your hand and you start your tawaf. Allahu Akbar when you get to the Safa and the Marwa. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Then you say the dua, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Allahu Akbar when we throw the jamarat. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Right? So Allahu Akbar, subhanallah, it is one of the most, when we slaughter, what do we say? Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. So it is the most beloved, one of the most beloved statements to Allah Azza wa Jal that we repeat on a daily basis. So like I said, takabbur in general, when it comes to a human being, it is not something that is recommended. It's a negative attribute. As a matter of fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمْ مَثْوًا لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. Isn't Jahannam the abode and the place and the residence for the mutakabbir, for the arrogance? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, and listen carefully, ya akhwan, whomsoever has one, or whomsoever have a mustard seed of arrogance in his heart will not smell, will not enter Jannah. Will not enter Jannah. Mustard seed of arrogance will not enter Jannah. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, does it mean if I dress nice, or I wear nice shoes, or I drive a nice car, or I live in a nice house, is that considered arrogance, Ya Rasulullah? He said, no, that's not considered arrogance. Arrogance is looking down on others and refusing and not accepting the haqq. Listen carefully, akhwan, because some people will never admit that they are wrong. Some people will, even their ego will not let them tell you hajj mabrur to their brother or to their sister. And they pray in the first row. Huh? When you feel, listen carefully please, this is very important. The minute you feel you are better than anybody in any aspect, whether it's in knowledge, in health, in wealth, in any aspect, you have a problem. You have a major problem. I'm Ustaz Bajur, who are you? Who do you think you are? Look where I am, look where you are. I'm the one who's talking here. Dangerous, very dangerous. I walk in and I have a big beard and I start looking at the guy who's shaved his beard. I'm better than him. I'm better than him. I look at the people who I donated 10,000 and a guy who gave 500. I'm better than him. No. Always consider yourself the worst. Like the ulama told us, you look at the older person and you say he's better than me because he had done more khair than me in his years. And you look at the younger person and you say he's better than me because he has less sins than me. Everybody's better than me. Everybody. Don't let anything, because all that stuff that you think you have accomplished, it is only from Allah Azza wa Jal. And he could take it at any second. At any second. So always be extremely humble. Be extremely humble and remember that everything you have is from Allah Azza wa Jal. And the kibr could destroy a human being. Destroy. And as a matter of fact, the opposite of kibr, which is humility, is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, the more you increase in humility, the more Allah will elevate you. The more you humble yourself for the sake of Allah, not for the sake of being elevated. Oh, I heard that Rasulullah ﷺ say, the more you humble yourself, the more you'll be elevated. So let me humble myself to be elevated. No. Humble yourself for the sake of Allah. Allah will elevate you from sources you've never expected. You see, everybody love you. Everybody respect you. Everybody honor you. Even though you did not do anything. You're just humbling yourself to the people and to the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. So the Shaykh said, don't get carried away with your wealth or achievement. No, it is from Allah, from Al-Mutakabbir himself, and not from yourself. The way to avoid arrogance is to remember Allah as much as we can until it becomes a habit. Remembering Allah Azza wa Jal, ya akhwan. You know, One of the, no matter what you're going through, every one of us has some kind of issue, whether it's financial, health, family, in-laws, boss, job related. Huh? Wallahi, try this prescription. Make your tongue constantly busy with two things. Astaghfirullah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Try it and you'll see miracles. Constantly, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Whatever you're doing, you're driving, walking, you have sitting, doing nothing, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, la hawla. If we think about la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, there's no might, no power except from Allah Azza wa Jal, every problem will be shattered. Every problem will be shattered. Subhanallah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Solve all your problems by la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. From the heart, coming from the heart with belief, with certainty, with yaqeen, with deep understanding. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. How do we use this name, Ya Akhwan? Like we end our halaqah every time with, how can we make dua with this name of Allah Azza wa Jal? Just like we took all the names before, when we used Ya Arham al-Rahimeen, Ya Aziz, Azza al-Islam, for example, or Ya Jabbar Jburni. Mutakabbir, every day, ask Allah al-Mutakabbir to save you and protect you from the evil of pride and kibr. Ya Mutakabbir, يا متكبر أعوذ بك يا متكبر من الكبر يا الله يا متكبر يا كبير يا كبير. You know when you say يا كبير and you really mean it, you know, يا كبير يا الله, every other thing will become صغير, will become very small. يا متكبر يعني نجني, save me from كبر, save me from كبر. Because no matter what, myself on top of the list, soon one day in our life we have fell into كبر. We have noticed or said to ourselves or felt in one way or another, we are better than someone. Don't tell me no. I'm telling you I did. I'm 100% sure I did. And may Allah forgive me and forgive all of us. But it's a constant habit. We might feel arrogant about our status in the community, or maybe about our wealth or about our health, or I see somebody handicapped, I feel better than him, or Allahu A'lam. But one of the greatest things to ask Allah Azza wa Jal is to save us from kibr. Ask Allah and beg Him to save us from kibr, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have promised a severe punishment for every mutakabbirun jabbar, for every person who is arrogant. There's complete difference between arrogance and pride. You know, it's good to be proud of your son's achievements. You're proud of your Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, your performance, whatever. Alhamdulillah, it's good you worked hard and you achieved. But always with the pride, you know inside your heart that it has only happened with the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. Only. Like now I spoke about Hajj and all that. Wallahi, I have no doubt in my heart. What's the difference between last Hajj and this Hajj? It's only Allah's taysir. It's the same places, the same clothes, same time, same land, same everything. How come last year it took us 7 hours to cross 1 mile from Arafah to Muzdalifah, and this year 20 minutes we were sitting down? 7 hours, 20 minutes. What happened? The people with me, they said, "Ya Sheikh, you scared us so much of Muzdalifah. Where is the scary part?" Wallahi, I don't know what happened. Wallahi, I don't know. Last year, 7 hours. We kept on, because you know the police kept on telling us, "Yalla, yalla, move." We could not even park the bus to go down and pray Maghrib and Isha. Then one police felt pity for us. He said, "Come down, pray Maghrib and Isha." We prayed Maghrib and Isha. He said, "Yalla." "Ya akhi, we want to stay till Fajr." He said, "No, now. Yalla, move." This year, we arrived. I was so astonished that I have to get up. And I told the driver, to the akhi, are you sure we are in Muzdalifah? This is not, are you sure? He said, ya Sheikh, look at the sign right there. Anta fi Muzdalifah. You are in Muzdalifah. He said, last year, 7 hours now, we are here already. SubhanAllah, carpet ready, Muzdalifah. So, SubhanAllah, it's only from Allah Azza wa Jal that I see it. We made so much dua and we put our trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Al-Mutakabbir himself to save us all from any kind of kibr. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala always unite our hearts. It was amazing seeing you all, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I'm so grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal that he put me in a community that's so loving and so caring. May Allah accept from all the hajjis that went with me. It was an amazing, amazing group of brothers and sisters. May Allah reward them ajma'een. Jazakum Allah khair. Barakallah فيكم سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. محمد عمر محمد عمر. So brother Ziyad just told me that his grandfather passed away 2 days ago. محمد أبو عمبر. نسأل الله العظيم سبحانه أن يغفر له ورحمه. اللهم اغفر له ورحمه. اللهم اغفر له ورحمه وعافه واعف عنه. اللهم أكرم نزله ووسع مدخله. اللهم أدخله الجنة. اللهم أدخله الجنة. وقه عذاب النار. وقه عذاب القبر. اللهم أبدله دارا خيرا من داره وأهلا خيرا من أهله وزوجا خيرا من زوجه. اللهم يا رب العالمين اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعله حفرة من حفر النيران. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. Yes, it was less people. سبحان الله. الحمد لله.